Welcome to our incomplete guide to the River Severn. To start off, let us introduce ourselves and tell you a little bit about how we ended up putting this together. From left to right, we have Alan, Rob, me, Smithy, Emma and Jodie.
For our goal to cover Edinburgh Wood, we fancied trying to do something other than a walking expedition, although we had already tried to do one countless times, but failed due to snow and floods.
We played about with the idea of cycling, horse riding and even sailing. However, we ended up settling on the idea of canoeing. The fact that we would be able to spend pretty much of the entire trip sitting down sealed the deal.
In order for us to be allowed to attempt canoeing, we all needed to prove our competence in the water and gain our 2-star paddling award. This led to months of practicing at our local pool. Then our assessment came and we threw ourselves down a river, capsized, got drenched and managed to come out the other end with a certificate.
This is a sizeable section of the River Severn. Our route was over 120 kilometres long, spread out over 4 days. The first day was 34 kilometres and started from the Powis Inn. We stayed there the night before so we could start straight away in the morning. Due to double booking, we were almost without canoes, but thanks to Iggy, we managed to get replacements.
The first day proved eventful. Smithy and Alan spent a good amount of time out of the boat moving trees that were blocking the river. At one point, we were stuck for almost half an hour. The two lads kept getting pulled downstream as they attempted to persuade another tree to let us pass.
We had set off at 10 a.m, and when we finally arrived at our destination, Montford Bridge, it was close to 7 p.m. We started unloading our boats at the campsite nearby when we hit a slight snag. The lady who ran the site had no record of our booking and didn't seem to be warming to the idea of just allowing us to turn up. 20 minutes later, we were eventually allowed onto the campsite. However, in future, we now firmly suggest that you should confirm your campsites to avoid any unnecessary frustration.
Day 2 totaled up to 33 kilometres. Looking at the map, it didn't seem too far. On the contrary though, the winding river meant that what was a 15-minute drive on the main road equaled to around 9 hours paddling on the river. While passing through Shrewsbury, we had to stop at one point to get around what is known as a weir, a small dam-type obstacle that required us to physically walk around with our boats, a task that took almost 30 minutes.
Our destination that day was the B4380. We didn't have a campsite that night, just a small corner of a giant field filled with sheep next to the main road. That night, Alan came to a sudden realisation that having packed nothing but soup noodles to eat for 4 days solid was a bad idea. Luckily, he had some tomato ketchup to add a bit of diversity.
After an uneventful sleep, we dragged our boats to the water, loading up with the equipment. Morale was not at its peak, as sitting down for days was actually starting to hurt a bit. For day 3, we were looking at a distance of 27k.
Eventually, we got a few songs going, though the only song that everyone knew enough words to mumble along with was Bohemian Rhapsody.
Rain was something there hadn't been much of this trip, but at this point it had been raining on and off for the past 24 hours, but towards lunch it stopped altogether.
We eventually came across a section of rapids at Jackfield. We had spent the last 3 days carrying helmets around, and this was the reason why. The rapids lasted all of 30 seconds. Smithy, who didn't think going down forwards was macho enough, went down backwards instead. He swears it was deliberate, we say otherwise. Rob literally decided to sit the rapids out, as his seat gave way as we hit a small bump on entry, and he ended up lying down looking up at the sky.
For our final night, we were camping at the Woodbridge Inn. At the discretion of the bar staff, we commandeered a picnic bench and actually had the luxury of a table to eat at that night. Day 4 meant the end of the expedition was in sight, with only 27 kilometres left to go. It was a long day, to the point that we sang 99 bottles of beer on the wall and actually got down to zero.
The most memorable part of that day had to be the journey home, calling in at the services and getting a McDonald's. 4 days of just super noodles is killer.
We really enjoyed the expedition, the team worked really well together, and I'm sure it's something we'll remember for a long time to come.